Not too bad. Thanks a lot, Fred. And good morning now, at last, to wet. Well, to Marty Pellow, Tom Cunningham.
Hello. Hello.
Good morning.
I'm very surprised there to see that there's actually not a wee sign there that says Glasgow.
Is there nothing there at all?
Shouldn't have the four of us all going on like our first album cover.
There should be. Well, let's make an appeal.
Okay.
I mean, people send them in, you know, look at them.
What is the most famous building in Glasgow, would you say?
Marty's house, probably.
The Mitchell Library is one of my favourites.
The Mitchell Library.
Or anything by Charles Rennie Mackintosh.
Absolutely.
Okay, well, a Charles Rennie Mackintosh model, seriously, if you're in Glasgow and you can do this kind of thing, about that high, about that wide, send them in to us. We'll put it on Fred's weather map.
That's great.
That's good. Put us back in the map.
This is people power on this programme.
I hope so.
Marty, you sing a bit, basically.
Well, I have been known to in certain circles.
But do you used to do a lot of Michael Jackson in the playground, in Smoker's Corner?
Well, I was always game for a song. I think that's purely down to me being I tended to be a little bit of a show-off, I think, but in a nice way. Cheeky.
There's something about Glasgow where they have parties, even parents and young and old do it, where it's like the spin the bottle. Everyone's got to have either a joke or a song or something.
Yeah.
And that's inbuilt within the sort of social system within Glasgow. It's that sort of working class sort of thing, yeah.
Right. Have you known each other since you were children?
Yeah, very much so. We all grew up together, we all went to the same.
Children.
Well, I wouldn't disagree with that.
Hello,
having seen you brought around here this morning.
Yeah.
But what is so nice about you lot is that you are still very much tied to your roots. I mean, despite this phenomenal success that you've had, you've not sort of whizzed off down to London, decamped.
Yeah.
You're determined to stay.
Well, us lot, as you said, yeah, we would very much believe in staying based in Glasgow where our family and friends are, which is very important.
You can lose yourself in London very easily because it's all image, haircut, going to the right parties, the right photograph with somebody else who's more famous, and try to move up a ladder of fame rather than musicianship. Whereas
so you've not done that then. You've not decided to stay in Glasgow because you sort of want to be true to your roots. You've done it because you think it's good for you.
I think it proves that you don't have to go down to London and you don't have to be in unfamiliar surroundings. You know, because that affects you as a person, and that then in total affects your songwriting.
Hmm.
So it's
doesn't
important.
It also? Hmm. Yeah, I guess, doesn't it also make things a bit difficult for you psychologically? Because if you do come from a very strong working class background, you've presumably got a lot of relatives and friends and neighbours. Who are unemployed. And
that's something that shows in my songwriting.
Absolutely.
I mean, our first single, Wishing I Was Lucky, was about unemployment and our surroundings. Obviously, we couldn't write that type of song again.
Because we are, you know.
But there's a bit of an ethical dilemma there, that you've been such a success, and yet you're still surrounded by people who definitely aren't.
Yeah, it actually works out quite good, because a lot of our friends live the success through our eyes. Like when we go back, or they see us on TV, they actually see the success, and then they think of it very much in a sort of social terms. They sort of look at us and say, it's not the band that's doing well, it's Glasgow that's doing well,
really?
Or it's Clydebank, the small area
we come from. It's their escapism as well.
And I bet they wouldn't think that if you didn't live there.
That's
largely it.
A couple of our friends are watching here saying, they're lying.
Well, I'm no.
Whatever the camera. All right, what about the money? Because you're very rich now.
That's a quite expensive suit you're probably wearing there too.
It belongs to Granada Television. I had to leave it here.
This actually belongs to the band.
It's actually mine, so these well.
You have got lots of money, and there was a time when you didn't have lots of money.
You've seen lots of money. I mean, can I just
what
come back here?
Right,
I mean,
yes.
You know, I mean, I have a mortgage like everyone else. You know,
right.
There's a price you pay for the ticket. You're in the eye of the media. You know, I would love to be rich and unfamous, as opposed to being famous and... Well, I say famous there, I think, I don't know, I mean, in the eye of the media, I suppose I am. But you know,
you're famous.
Tam, you're famous as well.
I'm famous, yeah.
Yours are famous too, yours must be rich as well.
I have to say that when we saw you in rehearsal earlier this morning, I was struck by the fact that, because you're going to be singing for us in a minute, but I was struck by the fact that you weren't in this.
That's right.
Because he was fired. You know, Tom's in the band.
I'm no longer.
You haven't told him yet.
No, I haven't. I feel this is a good time
but
to tell
never,
you.
But there's never a drum kit for him. You've got to take the hint, basically.
Well, what I just think, because there's five people within the band, we can all do different jobs. So Graham at the moment, who also isn't here, who plays the bass, he's away doing mixing.
Where is everyone?
You know, whereas myself personally, I'm quite good at doing a sort of speaking side of things, so I'll come and I'll do the talking. Marty's singer.
So we're having a sort of a minimalist version then of your new single.
Yeah. Version, you know?
Brand New Sunrise, it's
called.
Right.
The song is called Brand New Sunrise.
You all obviously get on really well. I mean, you seem like a really cheerful bunch. Do you ever have arguments?
All the time.
No, we don't.
All the time, they agree.
I think it usually just comes from a songwriting point of view, where we argue.
No, it does.
Well, you're going to go on and on. In fact, you've said you want to be a rock dinosaur.
Well, I mean, as I said earlier on, that's my sexual preference, but that's neither here nor there. No, I mean, I would like to have longevity within the band. You know, we want to have staying power and be a long
Well, you will unless a meteorite hits the Earth, I'm sure.
Oh, that's nice.
Thank you both very much.
Well, thank you, very much.
You both go off and, in your case, not get ready to perform.
Yeah, but you can leave anyway.
God bless.
See ya.
God bless. Right, that's about it for today, apart from them. Tomorrow we've got musical memories from international superstar Nina Simone, and Lenny Henry turns white for his first Hollywood feature film, True Identity.
And Japan's top children's choir serenade is set with a medley of Beatles hits, but we're going to leave you now with Wet, Wet, Wet and an exclusive arrangement of a track, we heard how exclusive it is, from their new album. It's called Brand New Sunrise. So we'll see you with a brand new show tomorrow.
Bye.
10:40. Bye-bye.
And moonlight walks with me, sunset talks to me, and all I want is a brand new sunrise. And city winds another fight to take the day into the night. My shadow. Talks to me now, and all I want.